Hi, it's Emily from Bite Size Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. Today's video is another installment of my interview with vegan activist Gary Yourofsky. Now, if you're vegan, or even considering being vegan, chances are you've come up against some anti-vegan arguments. Perhaps you've even posed some of them yourself in the time leading up to being vegan. While legitimate questions and concerns from non-vegans can serve as teaching moments and are valuable opportunities for education, some anti-vegan arguments are purely baseless and made only to provoke. In his vast experience working with non-vegans, Gary Yourofsky has probably heard every line of reasoning in the book. So I decided to ask him, what is the best anti-vegan argument? Let's check out his answer, and then I'll jump back in to share what I think is the strongest argument against veganism.
So you would know more than anyone else that there are a lot of stupid arguments against veganism. But what would you say is the best argument against veganism, if there is one?
There's not, honestly. I swear I racked my brain over this. There is no... In fact, I got a professor down here, University of Central Florida, who once told me the only reason he became veg is because all the arguments he heard against it were stupid. That was his reason. And he was a philosopher. He said, I cannot continue to do this because everyone's reason for eating meat, cheese, milk, eggs, and honey is absolutely fucking stupid. I really don't know of one good logical argument. It doesn't exist. But don't think that I'm exaggerating or being hot and hyperbolic when I say this, because there's not one good argument for raping a child. There's not one good argument for murdering a homosexual in Uganda. There's not one justifiable argument for denying women the right to equality in Afghanistan, the right to go to school, the right to vote. In Middle Eastern countries. So there is not one logical reason to enslave, murder, and oppress animals and consume their body parts.
I hope you enjoyed hearing Gary's take on this matter. I have to say that my thinking is rather in line with what Gary shared. In my recent interview with the popular blog Vegan Street, when asked what I thought was the biggest strength of the vegan movement, I said it was that we have truth on our side. There is no way to logically justify what we do to animals for our food, fashion, medicine, and entertainment. All of the facts and the legitimate arguments are on our side. This is reflected in the absurdity that often arises when people try to justify their behaviors. You can read my answers to the other 9 questions in the interview on the Vegan Street blog, which I've linked in the video description below. Now, all of that said, I do have to admit that there is one argument that someone can lay down for eating animal products that I have absolutely no defense against. And that is the statement, I don't care. If someone simply does not care what happens to the animals, the environment, or even their own health by the continued breeding, torturing, exploitation, and slaughter of billions of animals, I certainly can't say anything that's gonna change that. Complete and utter apathy cannot be argued away. Now, of course, it's not an actual defeat of vegan principles. As Gary and I have said, veganism has logic on our side. All of the arguments against it are shell games, admittedly by some honestly curious, well-intentioned individuals, genuinely wanting to know if this way of life is possible. And for those people, I will always have time and patience. Now, I'd love to hear from you on this. Have you ever come up against a formidable argument against veganism? Perhaps you have one yourself. I'd love to hear it. Unless it's bacon. That's a word, not an argument. But someone's gonna post it anyways. Oh, YouTube's comment section. You are the bathroom wall of the internet. Anyways, let's go close it out with Gary.
Gary, I just want to thank you so much for giving us your time. And I've been asked on behalf of so many of my viewers to just thank you for everything that you do. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Keep on. Everybody pass your stuff around. It's tight stuff. Honestly, bitesizevegan.com. Share it.
Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and please share it around to spread the message. Stay tuned to the Bite Size Vegan channel for more installments of my interview with Gary. I'll also be posting footage and questions that didn't make it to the main channel in the VIV area of BiteSizeVegan.com, which you can access for free by clicking below. And for even more behind-the-scenes action and the best discussion of all things vegan, head over to Patreon and join the Nugget Army. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday, Wednesday, and some Fridays. I would love to have you as a subscriber. Now go live vegan, and I'll see you soon.
I thought you were gonna ask me the dumbest ones. You threw a twist on me, like, what's the bell? Like, oh, shit.